Welcome to Goobertown Hobbies. My name is Brent. I'm a scientist, and these are laboratory-grade Funyuns. This looks like the stupidest experiment that I've ever done, but it actually paid off, and the results are super interesting. I'm trying to learn more about how varnish and primer affect the durability of models. Recently, I subjected some plastic goblins to crazy levels of punishment. Again, this looks silly, but it was actually a carefully thought-out experiment. In that grot mob were experimental groups to test the importance of primer and varnish. The results were surprising to me because all of the groups held up pretty well to this madness, even the unprimed and unvarnished models. There were tons of comments about why that might be and what I did wrong and what to try next. Science is an iterative process. If the results of one experiment give us new hypotheses to test, well, that's a step in the right direction. Not that this is a well-respected branch of science, but still. I designed some new experiments. This time around, we're working with Metal Sisters of Battle, and our main color is Mephiston Red from Games Workshop. I washed and prepared 7 groups of 3 sisters. I used rattle can primer, airbrush primer, or no primer. One day later, I applied 2 coats of red, either by hand or through the airbrush. One day after that, I used either airbrush varnish, rattle can varnish, or no varnish. Now, not every combination of variables is possible with the number of minis that I was willing to devote to this, so I picked variants that are most likely to actually get used by painters and gamers. I waited 5 days after the varnish step before testing durability. One thing folks wanted to see was the wear and tear from contact with human hands. Our skin naturally has some oils, but I wanted to make sure that I was extra greasy. I got some Funyuns, I put on a tank top, and I let my hair down. This is gonna be greasy. The goal is to pick up each mini many, many, many times with my nasty gamer hands. I also want to give each of the 7 minis as similar treatment as I possibly can. I moved each sister around this Monopoly board in a conga line, 1 space at a time. It takes 40 moves to get around the Monopoly board and back to go. I used some dice to help me count out 50 laps. That means I picked up and put down each model 2,000 times, for a total of 14,000 moves. This feat required almost exactly 3 hours and 6 ounces of Funyuns. That's 1.3 moves per second, and 179 moves per Funyun. It took me a little while to find my rhythm, and I changed my tactics a few times. But I did my best to use my left and right hands equally. After every lap, I cycled the lead sister to the back of the line so that they would each rotate through the 7 positions of the conga line. After I got into the swing of things, I picked 50 laps as an arbitrary but reasonable endpoint, and I adjusted my rate of Funyun consumption accordingly. By the end, there were definitely differences between the minis. Let's finish the stress tests and then evaluate. Another common type of wear on minis is friction from foam transport trays. I took a fresh sister from each of the 7 groups. My plan was to wipe each mini across the foam 100 times. I wanted to go back and forth across the foam while alternating which side the mini was taking the friction. I quickly found that sharp bits on the minis were getting stuck into the foam and keeping this motion from being efficient or repeatable. I settled for rubbing the head of each mini across the foam 100 times. The hair doesn't have any sharp points, so this worked reasonably well. I observed that the foam and some of the paint jobs were taking damage from this. As a final test, straightforward knocking around just like the goblins got. Metal minis are much heavier than plastic minis though, so this made me cringe way more than that goblin test. The goblins got 25 minutes of abuse, but after just 3 minutes for these sisters, it was clear that the experiment was over. Okay, let's see the results. Knocking around, there were no winners, only losers. Don't do this to your minis, especially not metal minis. For the foam friction test and the greasy nerd hands test, there were clear winners and losers. I've got the minis numbered. By the time I ran these tests, I had forgotten exactly which group was which. I graded the damage on each mini and then looked at the key. 3 groups took no damage in either test. They were no primer, hand-painted red, rattle can varnish, rattle can primer, hand color red, rattle can varnish, and airbrush primer, airbrush red, and airbrush varnish. Those were all three groups that were varnished. None of the varnished models took any noticeable damage in the foam test or in the greasy hands test. Okay, the group that took the most damage in both of those tests was no primer, no varnish, and hand-painted red. This makes sense to me. This is how things are supposed to work. Interestingly, no primer, no varnish, but applying the red with an airbrush took similar damage in the foam test, but fared much better in the greasy hands test. For all of the models, I put down the red with two coats, but the airbrush does a better job at getting complete and even coverage, and something about it does seem to be more durable. The two remaining groups to talk about are both no varnish and red brushed on by hand. One was primed with a rattle can, and one was primed with an airbrush. They both took heavy damage in the greasy hands test. The rattle can prime variant passed the foam test, but the airbrush prime variant took moderate damage from the foam. So in the greasy hands test, the losers were the three groups where the top layer was hand-painted red paint, and that's regardless of whether or not there was primer underneath. The three winners were the varnished minis. In between was the mini coated only in airbrush red. That took moderate damage from the greasy hands. So what's the big takeaway from this set of experiments? Varnish really does work to protect our models from damage they might suffer during gaming or transport. There's also some evidence that airbrushed paint is more durable than brushed paint. And rattle can primer might be more durable than airbrush primer. Both of those statements could use a bit more testing though. Oh yes, one more takeaway. Shaking metal models around like this is very, very bad for the paint job. This isn't surprising, but the way those goblins held up to this same treatment was pretty surprising. I know some of you have already typed this, but yes, the varnish clearly changed the sheen and the finish of the models. I used two types of satin varnish, but they look pretty glossy on screen and in person. I could definitely notice the lower friction on the foam, and when I was picking them up and moving them around the Monopoly board. Lower friction should absolutely translate to less damage. Yep, a next logical experiment is to try out some matte varnish, or maybe a layer of gloss varnish followed by a layer of matte varnish to dull it down. We've learned some things today, and we've raised some new and interesting questions. This is all as it should be. This is all part of the process. I'm in the early stages of planning some experiments with resin minis. I welcome any suggestions that you may have. No one experiment can have too many variables, but I think we're starting to see which factors are the most interesting for the sorts of supplies that we frequently use and the dangers that our painted minis are likely to face. If you were wondering, the 3 hours of moving minis around a Monopoly board passed quite slowly for me. That's too bad, because I think it ended up being a pretty good experiment. It's realistic wear and tear that's quantifiable, and it pointed out some important differences between our experimental groups. Of course, one way to make this experiment better is to double the length of the conga line and have duplicates of each test group. That's doable, but it's gonna take a lot of Funyuns. Once again, I feel like the results from these experiments were kinda cool, and I feel like I learned something. I hope this was useful and interesting to you. Alrighty, that's it for this time. Thank you so much for watching.